Welcome back to the second part of this tutorial series for this Australian Shepherd dog portrait.
In this video, I'm going to be placing all the medium range values down without paying too much attention to detail, and I'll be blending them in to smoothen everything. And then in the final part of this tutorial series, I'll be doing the highlights and the final detailing.
Most of these parts are the same. All these parts around the ears and the neck aren't as important as the mouth is. So the mouth I'm going to spend a little bit more time on. But once we get the mouth done, the rest of it should be pretty easy. I've got a blank piece of paper here to place my palm on it while I'm drawing, so to avoid smudging. So let's get started. I'm going to go ahead and do the mouth first. So I'm going to start placing some values down. And always follow the direction of the fur. I'm going to try and do as much as I can without the need for erasing the highlights here, just because these little sort of furs are really sharp, and if I try and do them with the eraser, they won't turn out as nice. So we'll do a bit of both. See what's happening on the other side here. Basically just comes down like this. Got some small little values around here as well. On this upper lip, I'm going to try to just create a texture that follows what's happening in the image, the reference image, without really placing too much values down, just creating a texture. Around here as well. And there's some darker values right here, which I'll smudge to match the reference image as well. A lot of the parts in this drawing have like highlights going over darker areas, right? So that's going to be done just by basically placing some values down, blending it in, and then doing the highlights over the top. Okay, so that's here and here. And these little ones around here, like I said, they're very fine. And I can't really achieve that kind of sharpness with the eraser. So that's why I'm trying to do as much as I can with the pencil as well. So I'm going to go ahead and blend this in now. Just slightly. Don't want to kill the highlights too much. What blending does is basically just creates some more values in between. So I didn't have to actually manually create this little gradient here. It just happens automatically when you blend. It just makes things quicker. I'm going to go over it with the highlights. That'll do. Now I'm going to go over it again with the pencil. This time, just be a little bit more careful. What I'm really trying to do is just achieve the same sort of effect. The fur doesn't have to be in the exact same spot. So sometimes it's easier to draw larger images when it comes to details like this. Okay, I'm not super happy with it, but I think it's good enough. So now I'm going to go ahead and start doing the rest of the face and the ears. And I'm going to start from the top left corner. Okay. And as mentioned, this part doesn't have to be perfect. Okay. What we're going to do is just place some values down and follow the direction of the fur as much as we can. And it'll all come together when we smudge and create the highlights. The main thing I want to do here is just try and remember where the highlights are in my outlines, because when I go over all of this, I'm going to lose all these lines mostly. So I can see that these outlines here are going to be darker areas going in. And I haven't actually created the outlines for where these lighter ones sort of go. So like I said, it doesn't have to match the reference image exactly, right? And we'll just figure that out later on. Going to rotate this to suit my wrist. Okay. So this here is going to be where this part is here, I'm guessing. If I follow the line down from the eye, I can sort of see that sort of just goes over. So actually, no, this here is, this part here is this part here. Okay. So actually, this isn't dark. Obviously, when you do this kind of thing, the more you take your time, the better. So I'm going a little bit quick, and that's why you get these little sort of starting points here. If I was a bit more careful and took my time a little bit more, I could avoid that. But it's good enough, in my opinion. Just depends on how much time you have. If you want it to be absolutely perfect, you can always work on that. You'll notice that I'm not being very careful as to where exactly where things are according to this, because it doesn't really matter. As long as you create something that sort of looks like it. When people see this drawing, they're not going to see this, they're just going to see this. So they're not going to be comparing it to the reference image and saying, oh, this doesn't look exactly the same, because it doesn't matter. this stage, I'm not really worried about making this the correct sort of values in terms of how dark they are, because I'm going to go over it again later on. So I'm just trying to create a texture with medium values, medium range values. And then we're gonna go over it again to create highlights and again to create darker tones. Last section, and then I'll continue down the bottom of the face. underneath the eye here. When it comes to these furs around here, it's sort of a similar situation as under the on the mouth here, where I can't create those kinds of fine lines with the eraser. So I'm going to try to do as much as I can with a pencil. So you want to just make sure your pencil is really sharp. Flip this around this way. So I'm trying to always do the strokes from dark to light at this point. Okay, let's do the edge here. Okay. So I'm just checking if what I've done is correct here. I can see that the line going down here does not match this. Okay, so we need to go a little bit darker around here. This area here is very light, so I'm just going to do this and then blend it and then highlight it. Don't really need to do anything else. Darker here. This area here, I'm not really going to go ahead and put strokes in because it's very blurry. It's kind of like in the background. So I'm just going to place some values down so that there's something there to smudge. And then we're going to do the highlights over it. Okay, let's do the bottom of the snout here, which is basically just some values that we're going to blend as well. These very light areas here are, you just want to sort of make something that looks like it, okay? It doesn't have to be exactly the same. There's a bit of shadow there and it's going to create that outline for the nose, underneath the nose. The snout, sorry. Yeah, down here we've got some going in this direction. I'll rotate this again. Over here we've got some going in this direction. A lot of this stuff can just be done with the blender, because it's so light. Now I'm gonna do this area here. Actually, I've already got values here, so I'm just gonna leave it as it is. And we're gonna blend those in. Some over here as well. The other side. Now I'm gonna have to flip this over again. This section here is probably a little bit more important than the outside parts. Okay, just continuing to work my way around the face here. I'm going to do this section here next to the nostril. Sorry, next to the... I'm going to do this section here next to the snout now. Again, it's just a very, very blurry sort of thing with a slight texture of fur. And then these parts here will be highlighted. So we don't really need to go too much into it. Just going to... just going to do this and put some values down with some general sort of flow to it. It's a little bit darker down here. Trying to pay attention to where this actual darkness comes in. It's probably around here. Just gonna rotate this again. Just doing this dark area up here. I'm just going to use other parts of the face as a reference. So where the mouth is, goes directly up, is about halfway down this curve. And where the end of the eye comes down, probably around there, so coming that way, around there, it's around here. This is where the bottom of the snout comes. And this is very dark here, but I'm just going to put down some strokes to maintain a texture. But I'm going to go over it with 4B just to make it a bit darker later on, and we don't really need to worry about what's visible here because it's pretty much all going to be dark in the shadows. Shape. on these flyaway hairs. It's the top of that bit there that comes across down, so this is all dark over here. Just trying to notice all the different sort of locks of hair here, little clumps, and placing down the darker values to make them a bit clearer. lot darker everywhere, but at this stage I'm not really fussed about it. So just to say again, this is all just to put down a texture in the medium range, and we're still going to pass over the entire thing with blender and highlighter, and also again with doing the darker areas as well. So now that I've done the medium tones pretty much everywhere, and of course some of the dark tones as well, but so I'm going to go through the whole thing and blend in all these values, and then we're going to do another pass and go through the dark tones again. When I use the blender here, I'm getting rid of some of the lines, some of the strokes here, and that's why we need to go over it again one more time, just to put those lines back in where they're needed. When you use a blending stump, try not to go back and forth like this, because where you come back, it sort of leaves a little clump of tone there. So try and keep it smooth like this. as best as you can. There's no rules with art, okay? I know there's certain techniques that you should be following, but really, at the end of the day, just do your best, and you're going to produce something that's special to you. That's all that matters, really. Don't get caught up in all that, all those kinds of rules, like no smudging and, you know, no tracing and things like that. Just do whatever's comfortable for you. If you've got an artwork that you're happy with, when people see it, they like it, that's all that matters. Did you have fun doing it? That's all that matters. And as I mentioned before, this whole blending process, it just makes things easier and quicker. Saves you a lot of time. Wherever you can possibly save time, you should. Just taking it a bit easy over here, a bit more careful. You can see here, there's like a very dark tones here, and then it gets a bit lighter. So we're gonna get rid of all that sort of thing when we do the next pass through. You can kind of see I'm leaving these behind. See these little clumps of tone here? Try to avoid that. Come down here now. Got a tissue here, I'm going to use that to blend some of these bottom areas here, just because I don't want the blending stump to be leaving little sort of marks behind. Sometimes it's a bit hard to control that. leaves a lot more of a smooth sort of result. For now, I'm basically just trying to get rid of some of these pencil lines here. I don't want to see them anymore. Let's just do it over here a little bit as well. And we're going to rub that out again to create those whiskers. See, this part is white, but this part here is kind of like a gray. So that part there is white, I'm going to leave that alone, but this part I want to blend it a bit. Okay, I'm going to go back to the blending stump now. Maybe I'll just do this part here as well before I do that. Continue along this side using the blending stump. Just blend all these values in together. Places like these, you can actually use the blending stump to create a texture as well. And I'm just gonna get my tissue and just do some of these parts here as well. Actually, I might use the blending stump for that as well. So just like this. I've got a different one now, just because it's clean. Just want to put some of these values down here as well. Okay, before I continue, I just want to make sure that I've got all the correct shades in everywhere. So I'm going to look at the reference image again and just compare it. And I'm using the darker one now because just in case I miss some of these areas that are not visible on the lightened one. Okay. So over here, obviously, there's a bit more dark areas, but I'm not going to worry about that now. I just want to see if I've gotten all the points around this snout. So I can see it's a little bit darker around here. And coming down here as well. And also around here, there's some parts. It's getting darker like this. And you can actually see the top half of his snout here coming around like that. And it gets darker in there. Extends over to here as well. There's some dark parts here. That part's gone over too much over here. I'm going to erase that a bit. And then up here, that's fine. Coming down over his nose here, there's a dark part. So this is the end of part 2. I've put down all the medium range tones and blended them all in to make things smoother. In part 3, I'm going to be doing the highlights and adding more contrast to the portrait by darkening all the shadows with a 4B pencil. I'll also be going over the whole drawing a final time to enhance and finalize everything.